Welcome to the channel. Today we are extending our functionality of the EcoWitt weather station with the addition of an EcoWitt WH57 Lightning Detector sensor. Now for those of you that have watched my review on the EcoWitt Wit Boy, you would know that when compared against others on the market, such as the Tempest, it lacks a lightning detector. And for some this might be a reasonable compromise with a lower cost for functionality that you simply don't need. But for others, this might be functionality that you are looking for. Well, now you can add this functionality at a very reasonable price and invest in the EcoWitt ecosystem. So let's see if lightning strikes in the same place twice and if this lightning sensor is worth the money. In the box, you get the sensor, which is made of white UV-resistant plastic and has no external buttons. It measures 123mm tall by 42mm wide by 14mm deep. The sensor transmits on frequencies of 915, 868 and 433MHz. An EcoWitt will sell you the sensor that complies with your region's frequency laws, so make sure you buy from EcoWitt. At the rear of the device is a battery compartment that holds two AA batteries that you'll need to supply yourself. There are four dip switches above the battery, with the explanation as to the settings on the outside of the battery cover. We'll cover what these dip switches do later in the video. The sensor is designed to fit inside of a louvered solar radiation shield to protect it from the elements, while still allowing for access outside. The lightning detector simply slides into the underneath of the shield for placement. Once installed into the shield, the louvered shield then connects to a 16cm armature. The armature can easily be mounted directly to a wall or to a pole with the included U-bolts. Now to be able to use the EcoWitt WH57 Lightning Detector, you're going to need the EcoWitt Gateway or console. I'll put links in the description to the different types. But if you have bought the Wit Boy, then this comes with a GW2000 Wi-Fi hub, which is perfect for the job. The sensor has a detection range of up to 25 miles. And by using the dip switches in the battery compartment, you can adjust the sensitivity of the detection from default through to high. Using the inbuilt antenna, it is able to tell you the count of lightning strikes and the distance from the detector, but it is not able to tell you the direction of where the lightning strike was or the intensity of the lightning strike. I'll put a link in the description to a Wikipedia article about professional lightning detection systems if you are interested, as it's a fascinating science. Like the Wit Boy, the lightning detector communicates with the gateway, which can be up to 100 meters away, approximately every minute. And these readings are made available in the EcoWitt app and also in Home Assistant. They are also stored in the cloud. But if you want this to be a totally local and not rely on the cloud, then watch the video in the pop-up above for storing information long-term in Home Assistant by using the Influx database. Before installing the batteries, you need to set the dip switches to the required settings. Dip switch number 1 indicates if the unit is indoors with the setting of up or outdoors with a setting of down. However, the instructions advise you to set this to outdoors to avoid the system picking up noise and providing false triggers. Dip switch 2 is the antenna length. The default is long antenna, which has a setting of down, and the manual advises not to change this. Dip switches 3 and 4 are related to sensitivity. The default with both switches down are for the sensitivity of between medium and high. This is where you might need to tune the detector. If you believe the detector is missing lightning strikes, then I suggest trying the higher settings with the dip switches of 3 up and 4 up. Or if you're getting reports of false strikes, then try the medium or low settings as shown. If you still believe you are missing detection strikes, then it is suggested to set dip switch 1 to up for an indoor setting. In my area, we don't get much lightning, but on the occasions we do, and I verified this with the Bureau of Meteorology, then I found the factory defaults worked perfectly well, but tuned to your specific location. Now you have your dip switches set to your specific requirements, it's time to insert the two AA batteries. Make sure you insert the batteries the correct way, as the detector could be damaged if you insert incorrectly. Also make sure you use quality batteries, as the sensor will be out in the elements. Nickel metal hydride batteries cannot be used, and it is recommended that lithium ion non-rechargeable batteries are used. You should now see an LED light up for 4 seconds on the front of the sensor. You can now close up the battery compartment, insert into the weather shield, and onto the arm ready for mounting your unit. I'll be walking through the pairing for the GW1100 and the GW2000. For the other gateways, you'll need to refer to the manual. For pairing, there is literally nothing to do, at least for the GW1100 and GW2000 gateways. Once powered on, the gateway will pick up the signal and include into your weather data. Now you can only have one WH57 Lightning Detector connected to your gateway at the same time. So if you are replacing a unit, simply power down the old unit and power on the new unit, and it will be reported in your weather data. As Elon Musk says, the best process is no process. Well, this has one step, turn it on. You really can't beat that. Well, should you buy it, consider it, or skip it? Well, I've been using the EcoWitt WH57 for a few months now, and it has detected a few lightning strikes that I have verified. So for me, this is a novel sensor that brings my Witt boy in line with other more expensive weather stations on the market. If I lived in a place where lightning strikes were prevalent and indicated more serious weather conditions, then I would definitely recommend buying it. If you love data and reporting on it, or enjoy monitoring the weather, then you should also buy it. But for the rest of us, I think you need to think about getting partner approval beforehand. Good luck with that. Now, if you've enjoyed the video, then please hit the like button. And if you want to see similar content, then consider subscribing and becoming a member of the channel. And if I've helped you make a purchasing decision, then maybe a super thanks or buy me a coffee. It's really appreciated. Until the next one, remember not to play golf in a thunderstorm.